Hearing the story, y'all. Y'all, I'm seeing a lot of stuff. And also, a few days ago, I don't know why. Well, I know why now. But I felt like I covered myself in the blood of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for your grace and your mercy and your peace. Thank you, Lord, for anything that you would have me say out of my mouth. And I pray that I would not say anything that you don't want me to say. Jesus. I'm pretty concerned about America. I know that we're all concerned about America. I know that we all see some issues, but it's a lot of issues, y'all. It's a lot of issues. For one thing, I don't know why, but I think I came across some YouTube video. I was looking for something else, and I came across some YouTube videos about Rwanda, what happened in Rwanda in 1994 and 1997. And I said, Lord, what a horrible, terrible thing that happened, right? And I'm telling y'all, I heard, like, this is what is going to happen. Almost like for us, like, y'all know what happened in Rwanda with the Hutus and the Tutsis were against each other. You would say, wow, that's terrible. And I think it was like 100 days of killing, 100 days of murder, killing people that look like you, just slightly different. In fact, they were both groups were Muslim. I believe, if I'm not saying it correct. Both groups were Muslim. And they were a war incited when their president was killed. Right now we're seeing presidents killed, taken out. I don't want to say for no reason, because we all know there's a reason. Very concerned, y'all, especially the dreams I had last year about like people turning on each other in like a civil kind of war. Anyway, I'm going to release the visions again. I feel like the Lord, because he keeps bringing up the old visions, and then he has me run into like other words recently, and I'm like just confirming the things I said a few years ago. Oh, she's so cute.
Thank you.
You're so pretty.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Beautiful little girl. Super cute. Keep the innocence, Lord, in Jesus' name. We need kids to be innocent, like. Y'all, I saw some things that just made me want to cry the other day. Because I was like, oh my God, we are literally headed for this in America. And it's like the Holy Spirit was having me study. And still. And he has had me, in the last few days, go back to Rwanda, study up on Rwanda. And all that happened in that war. It's terrible even to hear people's their testimony of, you know, all that they went through during that 100-day civil war, basically, where, you know, the Hutus and Tutsis were killing each other just without any kind of remorse. And I was concerned because you would think something like that, you would think something like that would never happen in America, but I know I heard Holy Spirit when he said that's going to happen here. And I get like, I got this in a impression, like this is the same thing that's going to happen here. So basically get ready. When you have, okay, so let me explain it from what happened during the Holocaust and also what happened during Rwanda. They literally got neighbors riled up to kill one another, to kill their neighbors if they were, even if they were mixed families, meaning, say the, excuse me, say the husband was Hutu and the wife was Tutsi, or they had Tutsi kids or something like that. And they would like stir people up, the militia groups and stuff like that, to shoot their neighbor, to kill their neighbor. Okay, so that's one part of it that is also true for the Holocaust. They did rile up. First, they kind of got the rhetoric to really go against Jewish people, right? And Germans to go against Jewish people. Then they started getting certain people in office who were anti-Semites. Then people like Hitler were gaining a platform. I see a lot of people gaining platforms, big, huge platforms that are very hateful, right? We see people gaining platforms on all sides of the coin. And now I'm seeing them, right? So the media in the Holocaust also had, in Germany, also had a very, very big role. Just like American media has a very, very big role. They have to rile up a certain base, right? So they have to say, they have to get you acclimated to thinking a certain way, to believing a certain thing. And I know you guys know this, you know, but it's pretty serious. I mean, this is how they went through with the Holocaust. They had no opposition. People did not oppose killing their neighbor. They had police battalions turn on people that they knew for years working in their same neighborhoods, right? How does something like that happen? How does something like that happen? It can only happen if you get complete compliance with things that are abnormal to do, right? So they got complete compliance with evil things, you know? Oh, if your neighbor's a Jew, you gotta kill them. If you know, they're this. First, you dehumanize them, make them sound or seem like less than human. Same thing they did to Black people, right? Sound familiar? Like when they say all these anti-vaxxers are the ones spiking the COVID cases in the system, right? Right now, these anti-vaxxers. I'm hearing like dangerous rhetoric in the media. And then talking to me, Miss Automatic. I don't know why I have to. No, it swiped it, it's fine. So just getting a few things here. Whoa. Let me move this. Y'all, I'm gonna have to come back, okay? I'm gonna have to come back. I just want to talk about this a little bit more, okay? When I'm focus. I actually have some work to do tonight, but I just want to talk about this shortly when I get back home, okay? I'll be there.